My testimony is my son that is schooling in Jos, in Barkiladi Polytechnic. He called me on phone that, mommy, there is something I want to tell you, but I don't want you to panic because you are the last man standing. Anything that will break your heart, I don't want it. I say, my son, that's why I'm here. Maybe that is why God kept me, only me alive. He said, okay. He said, something happened. I want to cross to the nearest village, me and my friend. Then we reach a certain point that there is a small river there. We don't know that Fulani people have set an ambush there. And then they run into the Fulanis, and then before they know it, the Fulani people just arrest them. 15 Fulani, all of them with gun. And my son said he got confused. And then after they got them arrested, they pull all their clothes so that they can shoot them all. So after they naked them, naked the way God created them, and then they laid them to lie flat. So my son has a mark, and he resembles Hausa people. So he now said, we are suspecting this one. All of them said that he should do this Kalma Hashahada. That is the way we Christians, we are saying our Father who art in heaven. That they should say it, that is in Muslim way. But my son is not a Muslim, he's confused. So he stand, he was looking at them. Then later one of them, that is the leader, now said, why are you wasting time? Why can't you just waste these people and then go away? All the 15 Fulanis, they now cock their gun. And then they're about to release the bullet and all the gun remains silence. Praise the Lord.
What do you mean by it remained silent? Bullet couldn't come out or it came out?
Thank you very much. And before then, he said, after he sat quiet, he said, because God tell me, this one is a clear something that I hear voice, that I should go and clean his sanctuary, that his house is dirty, I should go and clean. Since the death of my husband, this is 11 years, I hearken to the voice and I make myself, in fact, totally said, my life is. So after church, I hearken to the voice that what the Lord told me I'm doing, don't he, after the, he now said he keep quiet, he was confused. Then a small voice whispered to him that, don't worry, my son, your mother has paid the price. Honestly, that your mother has paid the price of your death. So from then, he said, he looked around, he did not see the voice. And then they released the gun, and then the gun remained silence. And then they are the one, they use their hand, and then give them their clothes, they are afraid. So my son wear his clothes, that is how the Fulani are looking at them, so they left. After 2 weeks, then the Fulani are busy looking for them again. So they now find him after 2 weeks. So they came in, that is in group. So the organa said that he saw him. Then my son was thinking, where did I know this face? Then later he remembered. Then he now asked my son, did you know me? My son said, yes. Where did you know me? Say, are you not the one that wanted to kill me and my friend last time? He said, yes, truly you know me. He now said, please, can you come with me? I want to have one in one with you. My son shift with him. He now said, please, can you take me to that your charm? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. He said, can you take me to that your charm? He said, since that incident, we have been looking for you. And everywhere that they asked, because since that time, the gun, all the 15 guns refused to work. We wanted to operate the guns and they refused to go since that time.
So since that time, the guns stopped working.
Yes.
There are some people you come against and then you are paralyzed for life. You are paralyzed for life. There are some people you attempt and then that is the end of your assignment for life. The gun stopped working since then. So yes. Can you take us to where you did that charm?
Yes. So my son now tell them that, which charm? I don't have any charm. It's only Christ, Jesus Christ. He is my charm. So they got fear. They now all stay aside. Then he now said, okay, can you be my friend? Please, can you give me your phone number? My son says, since that time, you people collected my phone. I don't have any phone number that I will give you. He now promised that is this week that they will surely return his phone. And they promised that if they come, they will not give their life to Christ. So that is why I have come.